fact that death is swallowed up in victory. Oh, death, where is the sting? Oh, grave, where is the victory? The sting of death is sin, but the strip of sin is the law. But thanks be unto God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. And may I suggest to you, my brothers and my sisters, that nothing can hold you back. Nothing can hold you down. Nothing can defeat you. Nothing can stop you from doing what you got to do. Because Jesus got the power and he rose from the dead. That's simply that you know. And no matter what you're going through, you can make a comeback because you got living proof that he is not dead. He's risen just like he said. And after the women saw the proof, the angel told the women,
yes, Lord,
you better use your energy.
Yes, Lord.
Watch this. The angel said this, that number two, use your adrenaline to tell the disciples about the masters. Let the church say, use
your adrenaline
to tell the disciples about the master. Now, when you get adrenaline in the text, well, simply, adrenaline has a connotation of going, doing something, and making sure you got the momentum to go for. Because verse 7 says, and go quickly. Verse 8 says, and they departed quickly. See, the affirmation that they had from the adrenaline was to go quickly and tell the disciples that he is risen from the dead. And behold, he goes before you into Galilee, and there you shall see him. Lo, I have told you. Verse 8, and they departed quickly from the sepulchre with fear and great joy, and did run to bring his disciples word. See, they affirmed what he said, what the angel said. The angel said, go quickly, and they departed quickly. Why? Because he's accessible. He will be there before you do. And that's good news that no matter what situation we go into, that God will be there before you go there. If you go to your job gonna be there before you get there. If you go to the school tomorrow, he gonna be there before you get there. If you go to college in the morning, he gonna be there before he get there. That means we have an accessible Savior. But then I love this next part is that they were amazed, they were afraid, and then they were amazed. They began to have fear in them. They were terrified. They were horrified for a moment, but then they ended up went from being afraid to being amazed and astonished at all of the things that have happened. How many of us can be amazed that if we go with intentions to find a person that's already dead, we go in there to embalm the body, but in reality, when we look in there to do what we're supposed to do for the body is nowhere to be found. We see that as a mystery, but in reality, that's magnificent. Because I'm so glad that beyond a shadow of a doubt, that these women, they was going to do one thing, but they left doing another thing. They ended up going, and as they went, the Bible says that they were amazed at what went on. And so verse 9 said, and as they were going to tell the disciples to meet Jesus in Galilee, the text says, and behold, verse 9, Jesus met them saying, all hail. And they came and held him by the feet and worshiped him. And not only must we know that there is assurance that the master lived, not only must we use our adrenaline to tell the disciples about the master, but the third thing that we must do is we must adore the master. Let the church say adore,
adore
the master. We have to adore the master because the text says, and they came and held him by the feet and worshiped him. The master Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, greeted the women by when he greeted them, the text says, they worshiped him. They saw the proof that he was not in the tomb, and when they saw that he had risen just as he said, nothing or nobody stopped them. What they did was they stopped what they were doing, and on their way to doing, they fell at his feet and they worshiped him. And that's good news that if Jesus could rise from the dead after being crucified for our sin, we ought to take the initiative to worship him and thank God for him dying. Without the shedding of his blood, there would be no remission for me in Galilee. Now, I love this, my brothers and my sisters, and I'm closing on this note. He says, don't be afraid. Rejoice, but don't be afraid. Put fear aside. Put your worries aside. Put your cares aside. What I want you to do is I want you to do just like the angel singer. He said, go tell my brethren to meet me in Galilee. Even though they abandoned me, even though they denied and deserted me, even though they left me hanging, I still love and care for my brothers so much that I still want them to meet me in Galilee. And that's good news, my brothers and sisters. That no matter how bad family members can get on your everlasting nerves, that no matter how bad situations can be in your life, no matter how horrible predicaments are in your life, the good news is that God simply said, I'm still going to show love to you in spite of how you treated me. And my brothers and my sisters, people may treat you bad, but Jesus is going to always treat you the same. I thank God today that even though Jesus teaches us that one important lesson that I close with is today. That the church must not be a place where we retaliate against one another. But the Bible and even the church must be a place of restoration. Tell my brothers to meet me in Galilee. And there they shall see me. And I'm glad this morning that beyond a shadow of a doubt, that this was an experience to remember. Because just the other day, his body was bloody. His body was beaten. His body was bound. His body was bruised. But I thank God that even though his body was beaten, battered, and bruised, that he still died on that cross just for me. And I'm so glad this morning that he had nails in his hands for the things I should not have touched. He had a crown of thorns in his head for the things I should not have thought. He was pierced in the side for some of the places I know I should not have been. And I thank God today that no matter what's going on in my life, that he died for me. Died from the 6th to the 9th hour. Died until the sun stopped shining. Died until the moon took a hit and then it dripped down and blood until two suns couldn't shine at the same time. Died until the grave that was in Jerusalem began to start walking out. And people began to literally see dead men walking. Kept on dying until that centurion said, truly, this got to be the Son of the living God. But I thank God that while he was dying, after he died and gave his spirit back to the Lord, that the Lord, according to 2 Peter, went down in the deep recesses of hell. Went into hell. Went, God Almighty, swimming. This is how I like it. That Jesus went through hell, went into hell, so that we would not go to hell. And I thank God today that whatever goes wrong in my life, that because Jesus went through hell, went down into hell, it stopped me from going to hell. But the good news is that he did not stay in that borrowed tomb. He stayed there all day and night, Friday, all day and night, Saturday, but early one Sunday morning. Took off a dying shroud and stood up on resurrection ground. That ought to be an experience to remember. That because Jesus lived, that you can face tomorrow. That because Jesus lived, you don't have to have no worries or no fear. Because Jesus lived, that everything that you need in life, it can happen. All because you have an experience to remember. Everybody standing around the church.
Thank you. Thank you.